Agriculture losses in the Philippines due to the El Nino phenomenon has breached the 9 billion peso mark. Details on that and more from Jervis Manahan, who now joins us on the line. Good afternoon, Jervis. What more can you tell us?
Yes, good afternoon, Stanley. Agricultural damage in the country due to the ongoing weather phenomenon of El Nino is now at 9.5 billion pesos, the Department of Agriculture said on Tuesday. Rice accounts for the highest value of damage at 4.6 billion pesos, followed by corn at 3.1 billion pesos. The rest are from losses in high-value crops, fisheries, and livestock. More than 175,000 farmers in the country have been affected by the weather phenomenon. Almost 164,000 hectares of agricultural land have been damaged. Despite this, agricultural spokesperson Arnel De Mesa said this is much lower than what they have expected. They're also hoping this will not increase further as we are about to transition to the rainy season. Meanwhile, the Department of Agriculture has extended the ban on onion importation until July this year. This is due to the higher local production, which meant there is a surplus of onions in our cold storages. The public can expect no spikes in the price of the bulb this year due to sufficient supply. If we could all remember, in December 2022 to January 2023, price of onions went as high as 600 pesos per kilo due to the seeming shortage over a confluence of factors. Asked how the agency is addressing overproduction of onions, De Mesa said it's not much of a problem since onions can be stored for a long time in cold storages anyway. Stanley.
All right. Thank you so much for the update, Jervis. The massive data breach at the National Police's Fireworks and Explosives Office, now considered a national security concern. The hacker carted away 1.5 terabytes of data affecting over 500,000 Filipinos. Jeffrey D. of the Department of Information and Communications Technology says among those whose information was stolen are politicians and government officials, including himself.
A lot of our important personalities whose lives are also in danger or there are or receiving death threats owns firearms. We are talking about judges, we're talking about prosecutors, most of our politicians also, right? I myself am a responsible gun owner, so my records are inside. This is a data breach that we are taking very, very seriously, and the PNP knows that. That's why we're approaching this not only from a PNP side, but now as a whole of government. It is safe to say that this is a national security concern due to the personalities involved.
D now hopeful they will soon catch the perpetrator. Cybersecurity expert Art Samaniego says the person behind the PNP data breach is one of the most prolific hackers in the country.
At first, he would like to portray himself as someone who hates the oligarch. He said they wanted to attack the oligarch, they wanted to attack the elite. But then suddenly they attack the group. They call themselves Op-EDSA. They attack government institutions which are not elite like the DOST. Hindi naman elite yung DOST. They deleted data. So from then on, I think their goal changed. Now they're just exploiting government agencies that are vulnerable. So gaya nito, they saw that the PNP and the DOST, they have the same vulnerability. Mm-mm. You know, sabi niya, it's not the security of the sites. The security is okay. But what's the problem here is that it's the human error. That's the cause of the breach.
Global tech and services firm Concentric stresses the need to further upskill Filipino BPO workers with the emergence of artificial intelligence. The Philippine director of the BPO giant says the country remains the world's top market for outsourcing. But Amit Jaga notes there's now increased competition as other countries catch up. Aside from upskilling, he also called for greater government policies to crack down on fraud and AI regulation.
Some of the policies that we're seeing at the government level in some of these countries is definitely helping them become more competitive. if we really need to strengthen this position even further. First is we need to go after frauds. We could come up with policies which make sure that taking action is quicker, and we can, you know, prosecute people, incarcerate people pretty quickly, because cyber laws are still evolving in the Philippines. If we make sure that those cyber laws are attuned to the kind of frauds that are happening.